Hello friends, welcome to Talkative Anjali's kitchen once again. You would have noticed that I have been off the channel for a while, and there's a reason to it. You probably know that I lost my father on 18th June, and and before that for 6 months he was very ill, so I was taking care of him. So just getting back to shooting a few videos, and today I'm making pineapple rasam, which is a very very simple dish to put together. So let's see what's the prep over here. So we have the rasam powder, which is key to the rasam, and that's what it looks like. Then we have tamarind extract. I have soaked the tamarind in water and then microwaved it for 30 seconds and allowed it to soak further. Then I have half a cup of pineapples cubed, which will go into the rasam. And then there is salt, there is one green chili and a few fried curry leaves, because rasam is nothing without curry leaves. Then there is a handful of cilantro. And I also love my rasam to have a little more asafoetida, so that is what it is. And I use Ramdev strong hing especially for my rasam and sambar, because I love the smell of hing. Preparing the rasam, I'm lighting the gas and I'm using this pan for the rasam, because nowadays my cooking is going to be for one person, and therefore in very small quantities. This rasam that I'm making will serve me for two meals. So let's add the oil into the pan now. So I've taken the oil. I'm adding about a teaspoon of oil. Into this now I'm going to add the mustard seeds and splutter them. So let the oil heat. I'm adding about half a teaspoon of jeera. Everything should go into hot oil only. Only then the flavors are released. हा रसम सर्दीसाठी खोकल्यासाठी खूप छान आहे, टेस्टीही आहे पायनॅपलमुळे, आणि मी थोडंसं आलं वापरलंय इकडे, तर ते आलं सर्दीसाठी म्हणून मी घातलंय एक्स्ट्रा. तुम्हाला आवडत असेल तर घाला, नाही घातलं तरी चालणार आहे. सो नाव ॲज द मस्टर्ड सीड्स आर स्प्लटरिंग, आय एम गोइंग टू ॲड इन दी हिंग. सो इन गोज दी हिंग, going to make the rasam smell amazing. And then I'm going to add the pineapple cubes. I'm going to add half a cup of water to this. Actually I'm adding about 3/4 of this bowl of water, and I'm going to allow the pineapples to cook. So let's check. Yeah, the pineapples are cooking. So to this I'm going to add the ginger. So I'm picking up this ginger. Now to this I'm going to add the curry leaves, the fried curry leaves. I usually fry curry leaves when I buy them and when they are fresh, and then stock it up in the fridge and use it whenever I need it. Then I'm adding one green chili split. To this I'm going to add the rasam powder.
just lower the flame when you are adding the rasam powder and allow it to cook nicely. Always use a deep spoon for rasam. So let this cook. Now I'm going to extract the tamarind juice. I'm going to use this extract. So I'm going to use about half of this, so about 100 ml of the tamarind extract to give it a nice khatas. That goes in and I will allow it to cook. I'm going to cover this up, let it cook for 5 minutes, and then I'm going to the rest of the extract I'm keeping aside to use for other things. I'm going to now cut up the coriander. After the pineapple and the tamarind extract is cooked together, I will add this coriander. So meanwhile, I'm just keeping this away. So in the rasam powder, I would like to add a little bit of chili powder and haldi. So that's a little bit of haldi, about 1/4 teaspoon, and about 1/4 teaspoon of red chili powder to give it a nice color. If you want, you could add any of your favorite other masalas, but I like it only with rasam powder. So letting it boil nicely. I have raised the flame a little bit so that it gives a nice rolling boil. Back, our pineapple has been cooking, and looks like it has been cooked through. Smells nice. And now we are going to add the salt. I'm adding about 1 teaspoon of salt and the coriander, a handful chopped nicely. I like the coriander to seep in its flavors instead of adding fresh on top. And I'm going to top this up with water. So a bowl of water into it, and it still feels a little thick. So I'm going to add another 1/2 cup of water. And that would be the right consistency that I love for my rasam. Maybe you like a different consistency, so you can adjust it according to your liking. Allow this to boil another 5 minutes. A nice rolling boil. Meanwhile, I have put the rice for cooking, and the rice looks nicely done. I need to drain the water, so I'll do that. Let us serve rasam and rice now. So that's the rice. Steaming hot. Make a little well in the center, and now we will pour the rasam over it. Smells so good. And more rasam in this little glass for me to sip from. Ooh, it's hot. And a sandge to go on the side. That's a very, very simple yet delicious meal. And I'm going to sit down to eat out in the balcony. So that is my rasam and rice, pineapple rasam, and the sandge which I ordered from Bangalore. And there's a little tiny glass of rasam to sip on. So I will take more as I require. But yum, it is just delicious. Sorry for the bad lighting because it's a little dull today and looks cloudy. So what you see here is not a very clear picture. The light is poor in the house. Bye. Hope you liked the video. Do like and subscribe and comment. I would love to hear back from you if you try it out. If you need a print of this recipe, go over to my blog Annaparabrahma and read the blog post and print it from there.